Hello everyone, I am Dr. Dinesh Deshmukh, working as an assistant professor at the Department of Chemistry, Guru Nanak College of Science, Ballarpur. Topic of my presentation is study of solvation consequences of some biotic compounds in aqueous solutions probed by physicochemical approach in temperature interval of 278.15 to 298.15 Kelvin. Introduction. As we know that almost all biochemical, molecular and ionic transport in biological systems take place in aqueous media, hence we have chosen water as a solvent for our study. The studied solutes, thiamine hydrochloride, helps to cure beriberi. Pyridoxine hydrochloride is used in the treatment of tuberculosis. Vitamin C and its sodium salt can help to prevent and treat scurvy. The details of studied solutes are listed in Table 1. All the solutes were of AR grade and used without further verification. All the solutions were prepared in freshly prepared doubly distilled water on molality basis. For temperature control during measurements, we have used Julabo cryostat and MK70 ultra cryostat. Methods. The density of studied binary systems were measured by using Lipkin's biocapillary picnometers. These picnometers were calibrated by measuring the densities of aqueous solutions of sodium chloride in the low concentration range. Our density values agreed well with the literature up to 0.05 kg per meter cube. The speed of sound measurements of studied binary systems were carried out by using variable path ultrasonic interferometer. The interferometer was calibrated by measuring the speed of sound in freshly prepared doubly distilled water. Our values were reproducible within 0.5 meter per second. Viscosity measurements were carried out using Ostwald viscometer, having accuracy up to 0.1%. Also, refractive indices measurements were done by using Abbe's refractometer. Our values of refractive indices are accurate up to 0.0001. These are the snapshots of density and viscosity measurements. During the measurement, Julabo cryostats have been used to maintain temperature constant up to 0.002 Kelvin in the experimental bath, which maintains temperature constant up to 0.1 Kelvin in the cryostat. Also, we have used MK70 ultra cryostat for the measurements of speed of sound and refractive indices, which maintains temperature constant up to 0.1 Kelvin. Result and discussion. Figure 1 shows variation in the density of solution as a function of molality for the studied solute at temperature T equals to 298.15 Kelvin. It can be observed from figure that density of solution increases linearly with the increase in the concentration of solute in the solution. Also, it is found that the density value decreases slightly with increase in temperature at a particular concentration for all the studied systems. The variation of apparent molar volume as a function of molality is shown in figure 2. It is seen from figure that V5 value increases with increase in the concentration of solute in the solution. Also, it is found that V5 values increases with increase in the temperature at a particular concentration of solute in the solution. Then acoustic properties. The plot of apparent molar isentropic compressibility, that is K5, against square root of molality is shown in figure 3. It can be observed that K5 values varies linearly with the molality of the solution for all the studied temperatures. It is also observed that K5 value becomes less negative with rise in temperature. It may be due to the fact that at lower temperature, water around the solute molecule is tightly bonded to solute and yields a high negative. Then transport properties. Figure 4 shows a variation of eta r minus 1 by root c as a function of square root of molarity for studied system. This figure have been used to calculate John Doyle coefficient A, B and D. Then limiting properties. To get better insight into the solute-solute interactions present in the solute, we have calculated limiting molar quantities and are listed in Table 3. According to Hepler, the double derivative of V5, that is D2V5 by 0 by dt square, can be used in characterizing a long-range structure making or breaking ability of solute when dissolved in water. Seen in this concept, our solutes, thiamine hydrochloride and pyridoxine hydrochloride, can be said as a water structure maker, whereas ascorbic acid and sodium ascorbate can be called as a water structure destroyer. Also, we have calculated dB by dt values. It is observed that the positive values of dB by dt for ascorbic acid and sodium ascorbate are obtained. This concludes that ascorbic acid and sodium ascorbate are water structure destroyer, whereas thiamine hydrochloride and pyridoxine hydrochloride called as a water structure maker when dissolved in an aqueous media. Thank you.